Mephibosheth was the son of Jonathan and the grandson of King Saul. When Mephibosheth was 5 years old, his nanny learned that Saul's father and grandfather both had been killed in a battle. She picked him up and ran away, but in her hurry, he fell and could no longer walk. Because of King David's great friendship with Jonathan, David wanted to show kindness to anyone remaining of Saul's family. He asked Saul's servant, Ziba, "Is there anyone left from Saul's family that I can show kindness to for Jonathan's sake?" Ziba told him about Jonathan's son, Mephibosheth, and explained where to find him. Mephibosheth came to David and bowed before him. When David spoke his name, Mephibosheth answered, "I am your servant." "Don't be afraid," David told him. "I want to be kind to you because of your father, Jonathan. I want to give all your grandfather's fields to you, and you will always eat meals at my table." Mephibosheth was amazed. "Why would you pay attention to someone as unimportant as me?" he asked. King David went even further. He told Ziba, "I have given everything that belonged to Saul and his family to Mephibosheth. You and your servants will work the ground and bring the crops to him for food, but Mephibosheth will always eat at my table." Ziba, his 15 sons, and his 20 servants did as David said. Mephibosheth lived in Jerusalem and always ate at the king's table.
And now for a report from a very, very, very gifted student at Mooseberry Academy.
Kablamo! Hey, Dash Smashem here. Lannis?
What?
Today, I've been asked to give a presentation about something I know a thing or two about. How to do battle with your enemies. You see, I've got a three-part strategy based upon my troubles with the most awesome biker I have ever known. Crunch Fisher. Old Crunch has been doing backhanded radial splits ever since he was... kablamo. I'd guess 5 or 6. He was highly respected by everyone in the tri-state area. Early on, we both joined Pack 144 of Junior Stuntman Society. And if I'm honest with you, Old Crunch was a bit better than me. He was a marvel to behold doing a three-fingered axle spin. Well, a few years passed, and it's time to elect a new president of the 144. It came down to Old Crunch and myself. Now you might think I wouldn't care much for a position and such, but in truth, I wanted it. Thought I could improve things. So step one, give him the old razzle-madazzle. You gotta give him some of this and some of that. You know, on the campaign trail. Show him why I should be the new president. Well, Crunch didn't take it lying down. He started getting mean. Like, real mean. Telling folks things about me that weren't true. That hurt bad. It's like they say, never campaign for president against your heroes. This brings me to step two. Give him the old Faraday square. You know, I decided to do what's right. Crunch was painting mustaches on my posters and letting the air out of my bike tires. But I played fair. No meanness. I followed that in step three. Give him the old work, work, work. I wasn't here to win a popularity contest. I wanted to help the 144. So I practiced and worked. And when all was said and done, I lost. Took it real hard. But then I won and became president. Because Old Crunch cheated. My first act as president was to decide what to do to Crunch. Everyone wanted him out. He'd lied and cheated, and no one wanted him around. In fact, Crunch started staying inside and hiding. I saw his bike just laying on the ground. I think God started working on my attitude. It seems like an awful waste for someone with his talent not to be using them. So I went to see Old Crunch, told him I forgave him, and wanted him back in the 144. Now I've seen him break his leg in 2 places, never utter a whimper. But that day, Crunch had tears in his eyes. He thanked me for being so kind when he had been so mean. I told him it's not me. That's the Jesus in me. So that's step four. We show God's love when we are kind to others. I think maybe that's the important part. That or the razzle-madazzle. Dash smash 'em out! Kablamo!